Electric charges and field, problem set 3. Two spherical conductors B and C having equal radii and carrying equal charges in them repel each other with a force of F. When kept apart at some distance, a third spherical conductor having the same radius as that of B but uncharged is brought in contact with B, then brought in contact with C, and finally removed away from both. What is the new force of repulsion between B and C? What is the new force of repulsion between B and C? Okay. So we can take two balls. One is B. The other one is C. And both are identical balls or same radius. The initial charge of B and C Q coulomb. And these are separated some distance L. So from the question it is given the initial repulsive force between the two balls B and C, initial repulsive force. Initial repulsive between B and C is taken as F, and K, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, product of charges Q square, so divided by the separation square L square, let the result be 1. Now we have to take one more identical ball, is name A. We are naming A. Initially no charge, so it is brought in contact with B. Is A B, what is the net charge, combined charge 0 and Q, total charge after separation due to charge distribution, the charge of A becomes Q by 2, and the new charge of B also Q by 2, so that Q by 2 plus Q by 2 will be equal to Q. This is no charge. Actually the initial charge 0 and initial charge Q, the total charge Q. Now the A is taken. Once again A is removed from B with the charge Q by 2, and C is, once again A is brought in contact with the ball C with the charge Q. This A contact with the C. What is the total charge? Q is Q by 2 separately. So the total charge 3Q by 2. Due to charge distribution, after removal of A from C, the new charge of A 3Q by 4, and new charge of the small C also 3Q by 4 coulomb. Now we can find new repulsive force between B and C. B and C and same separation L. What is the new charge of B, Q, Q by 2? New charge of C, 3Q by 4. Okay. Then applying the Coulomb inverse square law, new repulsive force. Let it be F dash K and product of charges 3Q square by 8. So divided by separation square, this is nothing but 3 by 8 times the initial repulsive force between the two balls B and C. So F dash equal to 3 by 8 F. Okay. And go through this. So just now we discussed, we'll move to next question. Four charges equal to minus Q are placed, four charges equal to minus Q are placed at four corners of a square and a charge Q is kept at its center. Small Q is kept at the center of the square lamina. At four corners of the square, minus Q is kept. If the system is in equilibrium, find the value of Q. What is given? The entire system in equilibrium, find the value of Q. Okay. So go through the question once again. Now, according to the question, we can take a square lamina first. Okay. The vertex A is kept minus Q Coulomb. At vertex B, minus Q Coulomb. At vertex C, minus Q Coulomb. Vertex D also minus Q Coulomb. So in the center, that is point of intersection of two diagonal, in the center there is another charge Q. To differentiate from the first charge, this is Q is kept. Q is kept at the center O of the square lamina A, B, C, D. Square of the okay. Now, what is given? The entire system at equilibrium. If the system is at equilibrium, is at equilibrium, then the net force at any point, then the net force at any point charge is zero. Why? Because the system is in equilibrium. The net force at every point charge must be zero. So let us assume, let us take the net force at A, F A vector is equal to zero. So in order to estimate FA vector, the total force at the vertex A, what are the force lie at the vertex A? So the force at A, that is minus Q due to B, repulsive force, this is the direction. So this is F due to B. F due to B. And force due to D, vertically upward direction, that is F D. And force due to C, again repulsive force, this is the direction. This is F vector due to C. All the three vectors away from the vertex, then the total vectors cannot be zero. As the entire system in equilibrium, at least one vector should be in opposite direction, and so that the vector addition can be zero. So we can take the force due to the point charge Q kept at the center of the square ABCD is in this direction, denoted by FO vector. As the entire system at equilibrium, the resolving part of the all the vector along the direction AC, the vector addition of all vectors along vector addition of all vectors, here force, along any line we have selected AC, along AC must be zero or we can say the other way, the numerical value of FO, the numerical value of FO must be equal to the component of vector along AC in this direction, so and FD, what is component of this, actually this FC, what is component of FD along the diagonal, this 45 degree 45 degree, so FD and cos 45 degree, and similarly FB and cos 45 degree. Okay, and what is the modulus of FO? Then the side length A, then diagonal length A root of 2, then the distance OA equal to A by root of 2, the distance OA equal to A by root of 2. So this K minus Q plus Q, that is modulus Q into Q by A by root of 2 the whole square. This is Q into Q by A by root of 2 the whole square. And mod of FC, what is the total length? A root of 2 K Q into Q, Q square by A root of 2 the whole square, so 2 A square. Then adding these two, both are equal, FB and F, and mod of FD and mod of FB equal 2 times, we can take any one, FD, that is K Q square by A square and cos 45 1 by root of 2. Cos 45 1 by root of 2. On simplification, and take all the common factor, K here Q alone, so 2Q left. Here Q is common. Then 1 by 2 and root of 2. Okay, then what about Q? Q into 1 plus 2 root of 2 by 4 coulomb. If the amount of charge kept at the center of the square capital Q into 1 plus 2 root of 2 by 4 coulomb, we can expect the entire system is at equilibrium. The entire system is at equilibrium. Okay? Yes. And we'll move to next question. Just now we have discussed. What is the next question? At three charges, minus Q1, plus Q2, and minus Q3 are placed as shown in the figure. Find the x component of the force on minus Q1. And look at the figure. The minus Q1 is fixed or kept at the origin of the XOY Cartesian plane. On the x axis, at some distance B unit, a positive charge plus Q2 is kept on the x axis. In the second quadrant, the third charge, negative charge minus Q3, is kept at a distance A unit from the origin. Now, what is the question? From the net force on the charge minus Q due to plus Q2 and minus Q3, we should find only x component of the net force act over the point charge minus Q1 according to the given figure. Okay, now we are going to discuss to get the result. First, we can take a Cartesian plane y axis, x axis, okay, x dash. Is y dash. From the question, there are three point charges, minus Q1 is kept at the origin. What about this? Minus Q1 is kept at the origin at a distance B, and plus Q2 is kept. What is the distance? B units. In the second quadrant, there is one more point charge, minus Q3. The distance of minus Q3 from the origin is given as A unit. And the angle between the line joining minus Q1 and Q3 with the y axis is theta given. And both are negative charges. So the direction of force upon or direction of force on minus Q1 due to minus Q3 will be a repulsive force. So this is the direction of force F at the first point F1 due to the third point. This is the direction. Okay, this is theta, this 90 minus theta, and this also 90 minus theta. Okay, and minus Q and plus Q mean there will be attractive force on minus Q1, attractive force on minus Q1 due to plus Q2. This is the direction of the attractive force. Okay, so we can resolve F13 x along positive x axis, y along negative y axis. From the figure, we can resolve F13 vectors. F13 and cos of 90 minus theta, that is F13 cos of 90 minus theta into I, the downward minus F13 and cos theta. This is theta, cos theta. J, yes, negative. Okay, F13. What about F12? F12 along positive x directions. Straight away we can say F12 into I cap. Okay, and what is the net force? Net force, that is F1. F1 vector equal to F13 and cos of 90 minus theta sin theta I cap minus F13 and cos theta j cap and plus F12 I cap. Okay, the question, we should find only x component, only x component. So x component of the net force, the x component can be taken fx. Yes, the F1 vector can be written fx I cap plus fy j cap, since the f vector can be taken fx I cap plus fy j cap. So we can take only x component. X component equal to coefficient of I F13 sin theta and F12, only numerical. Okay, now we can develop what is F13, the distance A and K, Q1 Q3 by A square sin theta. What is F12? Q1 Q2, K Q1 Q2 by B square. So this is F component. The question is the component proportional to x component, proportional. Proportional to x component is without common factor k, q1 can be taken. So q3 by a square into sin theta plus q2 by b square. Okay, so this is the and final answer. Then plus q2 by b square, q2 and b square I'll take somewhere. So the proportional part can be taken here. The finally the quantity proportional to the quantity proportional to fx is other than common factor q3 by a square into sin theta plus from the second term other than common factor kq1 q2 by and b square. So dear student, this is the answer. Thank you students.